Good afternoon, everyone. We would like to request everybody to please occupy the seats in front. Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. We would like to request everybody to please occupy the seats in front. Thank you.
Finally, the all-new Feast mobile app is here. Reflect daily with prayer devotionals. Watch the Feast series talks. Get to know our Catholic faith more with prayers and devotions. Pray on your own. Pray with a whole family. Pray with a Feast community. Be equipped in your service with our discipleship resources. Read and find wisdom for different aspects of your life with our growth plans. Journal your thoughts and prayers and write your dreams. Let the Feast app be your spiritual companion, your daily motivation, and your safe space. Download the Feast app today.
Feed your faith.
Do you want to nourish your home or village with goodness and hope? Do you want to inspire your office or business with abundance of faith? Do you want to bless and love the world wherever you may be? Then, the Feast Light is for you. What is the Feast Light? It is a gathering of two or more people watching a series of life-transforming talks given by Brother Bo Sanchez and Feast Builders.
God has a mission for your life. He created you for a purpose. And what purpose? To shine His light to others. To give His love to the people who are spiritually hungry, who are lost, who are drowning, who do not know where to go or what to do with their life. But your mission is to bring them closer to Jesus. How?
Scan the QR code flashed on the screen. You can also register at the Feast Light table or contact Tristan and Diane Olmeda at 0918-959-8826. Start a Feast Light now.
A sanctuary where bonds are formed, where hearts find comfort. Journey that goes beyond what is, touching every facet of life. It's more than a gathering. It's a harmony of shared experiences. A foundation of hope.
Of life's joy and challenges. A space for support and a sense of belonging.
A place where our faith deepens and our spirits nourished. You are loved.
Ito na mga order nyo, isang nilagat sinigang. Enjoy po kayo.
Ay, miss?
Yes?
Feast ba? Iyon?
Ay, oo. Grabe. Masarap ang cheese bread doon. Gusto niyo sumali?
Oo, sana. Pero okay lang ba first-timer kami doon?
Ay, oo naman.
Eh kung lahat kayo pumunta doon, game ako!
Ano ba meron dyan? Anong gagawin natin doon?
Jandy, may talk doon sa feast. Ay... Okay, sagot ko na po masahe.
Totoo ba? May worship po din? O di kaya may misa?
Oo, meron din dun.
Talaga?
Gina kayo? Lahat tayo pupunta dun.
Saan ba?
Valle Verde.
Okay, ready na kami mag-feast dun.
Thank you.
Magandang hapon. Maayong hapon. Buenas tardes. Anyong haseyo. And good afternoon, brothers and sisters. Please settle down. The feast Valle Verde will begin in a few moments. Brothers and sisters, welcome home.
Good afternoon, brothers and sisters. Welcome to the celebration of the Holy Sacrifice of the Eucharist, the solemnity of the Most Holy Trinity. Let us give glory to our God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, three persons, from whom everything in the world comes and to whom everything returns. We adore and thank the three divine persons for the mystery of the incarnation and redemption. Because of his love for us, the Father created us and sent us his Son to be our Savior. The Holy Spirit comes to us to make present in the church of every time and place the redemption brought by Christ to humanity. Our priest presider for this Eucharistic celebration is Reverend Father Edward Dantes, SSP. Let us all stand and greet our Mass celebrant, and let us glorify the Lord by singing the entrance song.
Now is the time for all people from every land to come together. Now is the moment for worship. We enter in, beholding the day. He's burning, it's all open. He's high and with prayer. Sing, sing it to the Lord. Open up your heart, make a joyful noise with the sanctuary. Sing, sing it to the Lord, lavish him with love. Let the praises sing in the sanctuary. Sing, sing it to the Lord. Open up your heart, make a joyful noise in the sanctuary. Sing, sing it to the Lord. Lavish him with love, let the praises ring to the sanctuary. Sing.
We begin our Eucharistic celebration in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mystery. Have mercy on us, O Lord.
For we have sinned against you.
Show us, O Lord, your mercy.
And grant us your salvation.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ. With the Holy Spirit, the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. God, our Father, who by sending into the world the word of truth and the spirit of sanctification, made known to the human race your wondrous mystery, grant us, we pray, that in professing the true faith, we may acknowledge the trinity of eternal glory and adore your unity, powerful in majesty. Our Lord Jesus Christ, our Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated for the liturgy of the word. To the Israelites, God reveals himself as unique and unlike other gods, yet close to his people. In response to this privileged experience of the one God, Moses says, "The people are to be faithful to the Lord and keep his commandments." The first reading.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "Ask now of the days of old, before your time. Ever since God created man upon the earth, ask from one end of the sky to the other. Did anything so great ever happen before? Was it ever heard of? Did a people ever hear the voice of God speaking from the midst of fire as you did and live? Or did any God venture to go and take a nation for himself from the midst of another nation by testings, by signs and wonders, by war, with strong hand and outstretched arm, and by great terrors, all of which the Lord your God did for you in Egypt before your very eyes? This is why you must now know and fix in your heart that the Lord is God in the heavens above and on earth below, and that there is no other. You must keep his statutes and commandments that I enjoin on you today, that you and your children after you may prosper, and that you may have long life on the land which the Lord your God is giving you forever." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be his own.
Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be his own.
Upright is the word of the Lord, and all his works are trustworthy. He loves justice and right. Of the kindness of the Lord, the earth is full.
Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be his own.
By the word of the Lord, the heavens were made. By the breath of his mouth, all their host. For he spoke, and it was made. He commanded, and it stood forth.
Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be his own.
See, the eyes of the Lord are upon those who fear him, upon those who hope for his kindness, to deliver them from death and preserve them in spite of famine.
Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be his own.
Our soul waits for the Lord, who is our help and our shield. May your kindness, O Lord, be upon us, who have put our hope in you.
Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be his own. O Paul reminds us that the three persons of the Trinity are at work for our salvation. We become God's children and heirs with Christ in the Spirit who inspires us. The second reading.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, those who are led by the Spirit of God are sons of God. For you did not receive a spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you received a spirit of adoption, through whom we cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit himself bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And if children, then heirs. Heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ. If only we suffer with him, so that we may also be glorified with him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please all stand to honor the Holy Gospel. Glory to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, to God who is, who was, and who is to come.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had ordered them. When they all saw him, they worshipped, but they doubted. Then Jesus approached and said to them, "All power in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And behold, I am with you always until the end of age." My brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon, Father.
Ayan, nabasa na ba ang lahat? Okay, sabi kanina, are we going to pray the Oratio? Hindi na siguro. Kasi natupad na ang ating prayer at binabaha na yung mga kababayan namin. While going here, ito mas amazing kasi hindi niyo ma-imagine saan ako galing. Galing ako ng Feast Bay Area. Oo. Kasi ako po ay regular confessor doon. Pagdating sa World Trade, baha. Na hindi naman normally nagbabaha. Natatakot yung mga sasakyan kasi hindi na sila nasanay kahit 1/4 lang naman ng gulong yung inaabot ng tubig. But anyway, I'm here. And today we celebrate the solemnity of the Most Holy Trinity. We celebrate the divine qualities that have been revealed about the Trinity, the Triune God, which are mercy, fidelity, love, grace, and fellowship. God the Father, Jesus Christ, His Son, and the Holy Spirit united in one God. The Trinity reveals the importance of being in a relationship with others. God has been with us, loving us from the beginning, now and forever. God's love and message are for all people at all times, from the people who live far away from us, those who live before us, those who will come after us. God's love and mercy will always be there. Before I continue, sino naman itong matapang pare yung masungit na to? Ako po si Father Edong, Father Edward Dantes from the Society of Saint Paul. Kami po yung matindero ng Libros SM po Saint Paul's Bookstore. Yung in-offer nyo, dun yung rin binibili. Kasama ko po si Father Pao, yung mas mga sikat kong kasama, si Father Albert. Ako po yung hamak na kasama nila. Pero ako po yung laking showbiz. Bago po kasi ako naging pare, nagtrabaho po ako ng mahigit kumulang 12 years sa industriya ng television. Galing po akong GMA7. Opo, bilang artista. Oh, ang laki ng reaction ng iba, no? Siyempre mukha namang hindi. Ako po ay galing sa News and Public Affairs. Ako po ay director at producer bago po ako nabudol sa pagpapari. And look at me now, yan. Kakaisang taong pari pa lamang, bagong pari pero lumang tao. Kasi po, when I entered, I'm already 32 years old. So hindi pa tapos ang Trinity sa inyo. Kung you are being called to the ministry, ang dami natin, no? Worship, kung saan. Humanda kayo. Pag kayo ay pinuntahan ng Trinity, hindi na kayo makakahindi. The Most Holy Trinity, ang banal na santo, in our theology class Ateneo, this was the hardest to understand. Not because it was incomprehensible, but because it was too technical. We say we only have one God, but why are they three? Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. So forgive me for my poor comparison as I try to explain what they are and why what they are not. So who likes coffee? Coffee lovers? Oh, mukhang mas marami dun ah. So ano po yung iba? Gatas? Gatas po ang iniinom ninyo? O Milo? Ayan. Kung coffee, ano po? Latte? Cappuccino? Ayan, tall with almond milk, half sugar, kids temperature, or very complicated coffee. Yung iba naman, okay na sa 3-in-1. Okay na po 3-in-1? Coffee, milk, and sugar. Yes, resounding yes. Minsan po, pinabili ko yung stuff ko kasi ako rin po ay assistant HR director sa St. Paul's. Sabi po namin, bili ka ng kape. So punta po siya sa 7-Eleven, pagbalik niya, 5-in-1 yung dala niya. Oh, very interesting. 5-in-1, nasubukan nyo na po. So we thought, baka kasi may ginkgo biloba or agaricus mushroom. So we tried. Baka may collagen, honey butter syrup, ang dami, no? Pero kung tingin namin, lasang 3-in-1 naman. Kaya pala 5-in-1, sinama sa bilang yung paper cup, tsaka yung stirrer. Masyadong matalino. We are only talking about 3-in-1. At nung kasagsagan po ng pandemic, may nag-try pong paghiwalayin yung 3-in-1. Coffee, creamer, sugar. And he was successful. After nun, hindi siya nagkape. Napuyat siya eh. Ang hirap ilangin. Pero every ingredient in 3-in-1 coffee is so distinct. Iba po ang kape sa asukal at ang asukal sa creamer. They do not share the same origin. Kailangan mo pang buhusan ng kumukulong tubig para magsama-sama sila. Hindi po ganon ang Trinity. Akala nyo, yun na yung example, no? Hindi. E di tapos yung homily ni Father, kayo naman. Nagpaka-late-late ako dito, tapos ang bilis. The better comparison daw po is the mango. Yan. And you look at the person beside you. Wala po akong sinasabi. Sabi ko lang, mangga. Wala akong sinabing itsura. Mangga po, pero hindi yung mango juice. Hindi rin po dried mango kasi medyo tuyo na yun. Yung buo pong mangga. Sa isang mangga, we have the peelings. Yung pakiramdam. Hindi. Yung balat. And then we have the core. Yung pong buto. And then especially, we have the flesh. O diba? Nais nyo bang mag-mango float? Ayan po siya. So ang mangga, ano po ang balat ng mangga? Mangga. Kaya nga mangga eh. Ano po ang buto ng mangga? Santol. Hindi, mangga din. At ano ang flesh nito? Mangga. Isang mangga, tatlong magkakaibang bahagi, pero pare-pareho silang mangga. One origin, one function, and one essence. Huwag lang po sana marinig ng mga teacher ko sa theology sa Loyola School. Dahil ako po'y babatukan. Ano naman yung sample mo, Father? Nandamay ka ba ng ibang tao? Pero this is one way to understand it. Pero ang siyempre, ang popular story about the Trinity is yung kwento with St. Augustine. While he was contemplating daw on the Holy Trinity, he was walking on the beach, palakad-lakad. Yan. That ba, nakapag-beach na? O tapos na yung summer. Wala na kayong chance. While he was walking there, may nakita daw po sa isang bata making a little pool. And then he asked, "Oh, what are you doing?" Sabi po ng bata sa kanya, "I'm filling this pool with all the water of the sea." "Wow," sabi ni St. Augustine, "that's not even possible." Sabi ng bata, "Exactly. Well, that is the same as trying to understand the whole mystery of the Trinity." Hindi po talaga siya madaling intindihin. Kahit pumasa na po ako sa complete examination kasama yung Trinity. But the truth is, in simple understanding, in the Holy Trinity, we have the Father who creates, a Son who redeems, and the Holy Spirit who sanctifies. They were never separated from each other. Akala ko nun, during creation, it's only God the Father. But no, the Spirit and Jesus Christ is also there. And during the crucifixion, the Holy Spirit, God the Father, is also there. Even in the resurrection. And last week, what did we celebrate? Last Sunday, I mean, Pentecost. So, during the birth of the church, the Father and the Son was also there. And when we look at these crucial events in our lives and the life of our church, we can delineate and identify them. Pero paano siya nangyayari? Kaya po siya isang malaking mystery. Pero if we'll sum up all of this into one, isa lang po ang kailangan nating salita. In Tagalog, ito ay ang pag-ibig. Pag-ibig sa pagitan ng Ama at ng kanyang anak at ang mga pagmamahal ng Ama sa atin na isinugo niya ang kanyang mahal na punong anak gaya ng pagmamahalan natin sa isa't isa, sa bawat miyembro ng pamilya, in every member of this faith community. God, as God of love, of the perfect relationship, through Christ, in the power of the Holy Spirit, we go to the Father for the oneness of creation and redemption of the world. It boils down to our loving relationship with each other, parents to children, couples to each other, friends among friends, and community members to each other. As we know, God is also in a perfect relationship. Yun ang sinasabi natin. God the Father with His only begotten Son, the Son with the Holy Spirit that He has sent as an advocate. They are mutually indwelling in each other. We have known God in these stages. In the Old Testament, we remember God, like in Genesis, as the creator or the nourisher. In the New Testament, the comforter and the savior. And after Pentecost, the advocate or the spirit. At hindi rin ako, hindi pa rin Father. Ako rin, konti lang. But our God is a God of love and the perfect relationship. Through Christ, the Son of God, the power of the Holy Spirit, the advocate, we turn to the Father for the oneness of creation and redemption of the whole world. So we model our relationship after the pattern of the selfless love that the Trinity shares. Sa huli pong pagtuturo, pinangako ni Jesus, ipapadala niya sa atin ang Espiritu Santo. This becomes now the fuel for our church, the strength for the body of Christ, for we are the church, and we receive the fullness of the Holy Spirit only in our church. Hindi po sa pag-iisa natin, pero sa pagsasama-sama natin. Kaya naman po, makalipas ang 2,000 taon, ang simbahan ay nagsusumamo para sa banal na Espiritu sa kapangyarihan ito mula sa kinakasan. Today, we also celebrate what? The week of the BECs, Basic Ecclesial Communities. Ito po yung, ano? Gamay na Kristihanong katalimban dun sa mga Visayas areas. Ako kasi, I consider the feast as one of the BECs, the small communities of God. Ang totoo po niyan, takot po ako sa the feast. Opo, noon ayaw ko magpa-invite because I fear small churches. Okay na dun sa parokya kasi after nun, hindi naman nila ako kilala. E pag na-invite ako ng Feast Ortigas, na-invite ako ng Valle, na-invite ako ng Manda, kanya-kanyang marites na yan. Kunin mo si Father ganun, hindi ka antukin. Huwag si Father ganun, nakakatakot. Pero ang totoo po nun, kasi I feel that I'm not ready for this community. But I thank the Lord and welcome the invitation. Kayo din po sana, as the Lord invites you to the many ministries that we have. Jesus Christ told us that our Father, His Father, never refused someone who asked for the Holy Spirit. So ask, let us ask over and over again. If there is one prayer suited for this, whether we are expressing our triumphs, our failures, our cowardness, fear, or victory, our confidence. For all people of all ages, it's no other than the prayer, come, Holy Spirit, please pray with me. Come, Holy Spirit. And to close, can we look at how we make the sign of the cross? How do we make the sign of the cross? In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. We look at how we make the sign of the cross. When we say, in the name of the Father, again, everyone, in the name of the Father, we mark our forehead, our intellect, is the one who guides us. And then the Son, that's in our heart, but near the womb for the women, just like Jesus was in the womb of Mary. And then when we say, Holy Spirit, it's like God embracing us, telling us we're also loved and beloved. We will all be caught up in this relationship, the web of loving, in the love of the Most Holy Trinity. As we say, please join in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. We stand as we profess our faith. I believe
in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who was spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
God is our Creator and Father. He has given us His Son to be our life. His Holy Spirit, let us raise our voices as we pray. Lord, listen to your people.
Lord, listen to your people.
May our church leaders be docile to the voice of the Holy Spirit, faithful to the way of Christ, and diligent in listening to the divine word and in approaching the wellspring of grace.
Lord, listen to your people.
May the Holy Spirit strengthen the leaders of our country in their commitment to all truth, peace, and justice. We pray.
Lord, listen to your people.
May consecrated men and women show forth their love for the poor and the oppressed. May they be one with those in need and abound in works of mercy. May they be compassionate toward all. We pray.
Lord, listen to your people.
May those who are suffering because of sickness, poverty, and difficulty in their relationships be sustained by the love of God and through the care of their families and friends. We pray.
Lord, listen to your people.
May the Lord bless efforts and initiatives of all the parishioners who compose the parish and the ECs. may the spirit of collaboration bring us into a fruitful communion with the Father. We pray,
Lord, listen to your people.
May our departed brothers and sisters be welcomed into the kingdom of eternal life. We pray,
Lord, listen to your people.
For the prayer intention of our Holy Father, Pope Francis, for the month of May, pray religious men and women, seminarians, to grow in their own vocations, to their human, pastoral, spiritual, and community formation, leading them to be credible witnesses to the gospel. Pray,
Lord, listen to your people.
For the feast, or this feast valley bearer, our district builder, feast builders, leaders, and servants, may we strongly unite towards making disciples according to the directions set by our regional builders, aligned with Brother Bo's vision for the feast. We pray,
Lord, listen to your people.
Let us pray for the urgent concerns of our community and for one another. We pray,
Lord, listen to your people.
Almighty Father, you have revealed your love to us, your Son, and send the Holy Spirit among us. Receive our prayers, and grant that we come to the inheritance held out to us in Christ, who lives and reigns with you forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated. We will now have the offering of the bread and wine, symbols of the fruit of our hard-earned labor of the week. Please join in the singing of the offertory song.
Lord, we lift up to you all these gifts we offer for your glory. With this spirit bright, we will join us in the call, and feel your presence flowing on. As we offer this bread, and as we pray with this wine, bless them, Lord Jesus. Bring us now, give us life, send us your spirit, the swords of your light, together we will live. As we offer this bread, and as we bring you this wine, blessed Lord Jesus, in the spell, with the spell, send us your spirit, the source of our lives, and together we will serve you.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that their sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice for the grace and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Let us pray. Sanctified by the invocation of your name, we pray, O Lord, our God, this oblation of our service, and by it make us an eternal offering to you. Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
and with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For through your only begotten Son and the Holy Spirit, you are one God, one Lord, not in the unity of a single person, but in a trinity of substance. For what you have revealed to us of your glory, we believe equally of your Son and of the Holy Spirit, so that in confessing of the true and eternal Godhead, you might be adored in what is proper to each person, their unity in substance and their equality in majesty. For this is praised by angels and archangels, cherubim too and seraphim, who never cease to cry out each day as with one voice they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took the bread, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for me, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy in your presence and ministered to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring us to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Milo Yubo, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them in the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, the most chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles, Saint Paul, all the saints who please you throughout the ages, who may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and glory forever. At the Savior's command, informed by the divine teaching, we dare.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Deliver us, O Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graces and grant peace in our days, that by the help of mercy we may be always free from sin, and save from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave, my peace I give, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
We offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace be with you.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
God and God of Christ, bring us over God's life.
Amen. For orderly communion, please be seated and wait for the ushers to guide you.
The body.
Act of Spiritual Communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Most Holy Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot, at this moment, receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly. Act of Spiritual Communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Most Holy Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot, at this moment, receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And
emptiness in the heart, in the
Please rise.
Let us pray. May receiving this sacrament, O Lord our God, bring us health of soul, as we rest in eternal Holy Trinity and by Christ our Lord.
Amen. The feast will continue with a powerful worship and an inspiring talk after the Mass. Please be with us and be blessed even more. Praise and thank the Lord for sending Father Edward for celebrating the Holy Mass with us. Thank you, Father.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing. May the Lord bless you and keep you.
Amen.
May he let his face shine upon you and show you his mercy.
Amen.
May he turn his countenance towards you and give you his peace.
Amen.
And may the blessing of the Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Our celebration is ended. Go in the peace and love of our triune God.
Thanks to God.
Nothing without you, you fill me up with joy. Nothing without you, I come to you. Now you hold me as your own. You know what you're showing me. Just keep falling down. To see your kingdom come, I'm running, declaring the life you want for me, the work you've done in me. So here now I am singing, I won't stay silent, won't keep my eyes on you. And all the things you do, not holding back, no price that's true. You. Oh, oh, I give to you, I won't stay silent, won't keep my eyes off you.
What's up, Feast Valle Verde family? Let's make some noise! Please turn your attention to the screen for some announcements. Calling all youth in the house! Join us at the Youth Corner every week after the feast for blessings, stories, and more. Bring your siblings, classmates, and friends who are youth too. See you there. Hey, singles! The FBV Singles Ministry invites you to Save Space, a quick weekly get-together after the feast. Meet new friends, interact, and have real-life conversations. It's a safe space for everyone. See you later, singles. The Light of Jesus Family Pastoral Care Center, or LOJ-BCC, invites you to the special advanced screening of Inside Out 2 on June 22, 2024 at 3 p.m. at the Robinson's Galleria Cinema 1. This fundraising event supports mental health and emotional literacy, and all proceeds will benefit LOJ-BCC services. Tickets are available at 650 pesos. Get yours now by texting Sis Ellie Tiglao at 0923-132-3071 or register at bit.ly/insideout2LOJ-BCC. You can also message them on their Facebook account. See you there. Let's plant seeds of faith and help in the mission of making disciples. Be a feast light planter and journey with someone to get to know Jesus more. Scan the QR code on the screen to register for a feast light quick start or approach the feast light table near the entrance. To download our latest feast bulletin, you may scan the QR code on the screen. Thank you. Hi. And now, let's all stand up and come to worship.
Praise God! Good afternoon, Peace Valley of Verdes! Woo! Yan! Ito, as one tayo, sisigaw tayo na good afternoon. Because we are one church, we are one in the Trinity, and triune God. So, when I say good afternoon, gusto ko marinig yung busog na busog na good afternoon. 1, 2, 3, good afternoon, Feast Valley Verde! Praise God, hallelujah! Brothers and sisters, welcome to the place where love overflows. Could you tell the person beside you, could you greet the person beside you, sabihin, smile, because the world needs your smile. Ayan, smile! Praise God, hallelujah! Brothers and sisters, can I tell you one short story? Okay lang ba?
Amen. Sino dito ang may mga pamangkin? Yun! One day, kasama ko yung pamangkin ko. Sabi ko, pupunta tayo sa beach. Tapos, yung, yan, yay! Yung pamangkin kong yun, never pa niya naka, never pa siya nakita ng beach. Ang alam lang niya, swimming pool. So when we went to the beach, pagdating namin, paglabas niya ng sasakyan, pagtungtong doon sa beach, alam niyo yung eyes niya, yung mata niya, he was in disbelief. He was just right there standing and then he was just in awe. Sobrang lawak ng swimming pool. Sobrang, para sa kanya, grabe ang lawak. Hindi na niya makita yung dulo ng horizon. And nakita niya yung waves was just keep on coming and coming and coming. And the wind was so beautiful. Brothers and sisters, he was so much in awe and in wonder of what he was seeing. Bakit po kinikwento to? Ask me why. When was the last time you stepped back from your work, from your relationships, from your problems in life, and just stood back and just said, Lord, how wonderful is your creation? Have you asked yourself that? Brothers and sisters, this moment in time, I invite you that we will step back from whatever you have, whatever burdens you may have, fears, anxieties, worry, sickness even. Despite all of that, we step back and just say, Lord, thank you for my life. I am still breathing without thinking that I need to breathe. Our blood is still flowing in my body without me thinking that it should flow in my body. Brothers and sisters, we are alive because we have a wonderful God. Let us now look to God and see Him in wonder. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Healing to the wonder of His grace, of His happiness, mercy. So with the prayer,
The cool days are here. Can you kindly look at the smile of your friend beside you? Dalawang araw, kamakalawa yung mga ngiti ng ganyan. Sobrang mainit, mainit yung mga ulo ng mga tao. No? Sa mga sales ngayon, tatagal lang. Alright. I'm happy because I'm seeing friends from my group coaching, Sunju. I see my inaanaps. I see people na anaking kasal, hun. Ang topic natin today will be talk number 4, sadness. Hindi ko natatanong kung nakaka-relate ka ba. Masaya lang ako sa mga taong, anong talk ngayon? Sadness. Ay, hindi na ako nakaka-relate. Next! But we will be discussing this because this kind of emotion is something that we will need along the way. But how long you have been so sad before, at least in your personal history. OMG. Today, we will discover how to manage sadness, and we will look at sadness from different angles and learn from it. Kasi may gustong ituro ang kalungkutan sa atin. How many of you are praying for people? Raise your hand. That's the secret. You always attend the feast, bringing with you all your prayers. Do not attend the feast without any intention to pray. Huwag kang attend kasi feel mo lang. O nga, feels, no? But you attend because you represent your family, your company, your visa application, your travel abroad, your present, and most of all, ask me what? Ngitian mo yung katabi mo, sabi mo, our beauty. Yes! Palakpakan natin si Lord! God is good! I'm so stoked because, you know, young people are serving here. Palakpakan natin ating banda. And the most amazing of all singers, the youth in front of me. So we come before the presence of God in the name of the Father and of the Son of the Holy Spirit. Raise up both hands in full surrender. Never allow any area of your life with it. Door and window still closed. Buksan ang lahat. Your intellect, your emotion, your past, your future, your profession, even your secret life. There's no such thing because God can see you through and through. Today, as a church, as a community, as a feast, we declare Today I receive all of God's love for me. Today I open myself to the unbounded. Today I open myself to God's blessings, healing, and miracles. Today I open myself to God's word so that I become more like Jesus every day. Today I proclaim that I'm God's beloved, I'm God's servant, I am God's powerful champion. And because I am blessing the world in Jesus' name. That you will say, give the Lord a big, big hand, everybody. Let us honor the word. Again, hindi lahat makakarelate sa scripture, pero beware because you might think that you are not sad, but sometimes there are sadness that are unaddressed. Iwas-iwasan mo, pero sometimes the most right thing to feel is to feel sad. Oo, pagtatanggol ko, maging abogado ako ni sadness ngayon. Anyway, we read from Psalm 34, verse 18. Let's read it together. The Lord is close, akbayan ang katabi. Sabi mo, close pala kayo ni Lord dati. Brother Robert, ba't dati? Eh, kasi namimiss ka ni Lord tuwing brokenhearted, dumula siya naaalala eh. Kaya paminsan-minsan, may pinapadala sa'yo para tulungan so you could relate. Please never forget. God will heal you, but never forget the times when you are broken. And please get ready because the road to heaven is filled with so much heartaches and service of the Lord. But there's no other more meaningful life than church life, than serving the Lord. Amen? So we read on. The Lord is close to the brokenhearted and saves those who are crushed in spirit. Place your hand over your heart and say this with me. Lord, I may not feel or even see area of my life, profession, family, secret life that might be more appropriate to feel sad about. I offer my life to you, Lord. Whisper this at the heart of God. Heal me. Give the Lord a big hand, everybody, and honor the word. Music ministers! Let's give the Lord a big, big hand. Let's rejoice. Come on, everybody. Make some noise. All right. Akbayan ang katabi. Sabihin mo, dahil kaibigan mo ako, mula ngayon, hindi ka na mag-iisa. Please, Valle Verde, even those who attended for the first time, make everybody feel that they belong here. Go around and hug as many persons as you can while the song is being sung. I hear the ticking of the clock. I'm lying in the room, beach dark. Lalim. You know the song, sing along. I'm wondering where you're going. No answer on the telephone. Once upon a time, you're so lonely, right? When the night goes by, so very slow. Oh, yes. Oh, I hope that it won't end, no. Here we go, if you know the song. Till now, I always get by on my own. I never really get up till I'm at you. And now it chills me to the bone. How do I make you alone? How do I make you alone? Rocket Minister!
really cared until I met you.
And now it chills me to the bone.
How do I get you alone? How do I get you alone?
Everybody! Thank you, April and Justin. And of course, Alpi, palakpakan ng ating malulupit na singer. They always make me sound like a rock star. I have a one big message for you. Get ready for this. Place your hand over your heart. The one big message is, the Lord heals the broken. Humanap ng katabi kahit di mo kilala. Pag kilala mo, mas maigi. Alam mo, once upon a time, broken yung taong yan. Pag hindi pakiramdam mo mula, parang broken to dati. Pakiulit sa kanya, the Lord heals the broken. Okay. Dahil alam kong matatalino ang umaaten ng Feast Valle Verde, meron akong tanong, no. Tanungin niyo ako, no. Ano ang paboritong shampoo ni Zorro? Yeah, ni-research ko to. Ang naka-answer ay si Brad Pitt. At may sinite siyang scripture na out of this world. Gusto yung malaman anong paboritong shampoo ni Zorro? Ayon daw sa Whispering Hope. Ito daw. Whispering Hope. Oh, how welcome that voice, making my heart in its sorrow. Ano ang paboritong shampoo ni Zorro? Rejoice, palakpakan natin si Lord. Bakit mo ninaknak yun? Wala lang. Hindi, ninaknak ko yun kasi another word for sadness is sorrow, hindi Zorro. Zorro is, I think, is a Spanish word for fox. Yung asong gubat. Alright. Anyway, I dedicate this discussion to those who have moved on already, to those who are going through some rough times, to those who would be facing some heartaches. Kasi ganun yata ang mundo. May mali akong sharing sa inyo. I used to call it permissive will. Mali ako sa turo, I would like to correct it, debunk myself. Permissive will pala is this. Are you ready? Permissive will is that, sige na nga, a-answerin ko yung gusto mo. Pero dahil sa ginusto mo, napasama ka, pero natuto ka dahil pinagbigyan ka ni Lord. So you just pray na hindi lahat ng hinihingi mo kay Lord, bibigay niya, or baka ibigay niya, ikasasama mo, pero matututo ka. Did that make sense? Halimbawa, Lord, boyfriend naman dyan. Eh, pinipilian ka pa nga ni Lord. Tapos nagkaroon ka mukha namang timang. Tapos tinimang din buhay mo. Yun yung permissible. Pinayagan ni Lord, pero nasaktan ka, pero may natutunan ka. Or a company that you applied, or a business transaction that pinilit mo si Lord. So minsan pala, yun yung permissive will. But what I want to share with you is the ultimate will. The ultimate will of God is all for your good. Ikabubuti mo, Mark. Oh, tamo. Ikabubuti ni Alfie. Sabi mo sa katabi mo, ikabubuti mo. Tapos ngitian mo siya, sabi mo, kahit may heartache. Kasi tayo, gusto natin ang buhay na walang pinagdadaanan. At i-dedicate ko to sa mga taong umaaten ng feast sa tatlong kadahilanan. Show it in the screen. The breaking, the broken, and the broke. Titigan mo mabuti. Ayan, no? Basag na basag yan. Nananaginip ng gising. Breaking. Brother, ano yung breaking? May pinagdadaanan. Emotional ba? Psychological ba? Financial ba? You're breaking. At wag mo akong bibiglayin, brother. Break it to me gently. Ganun yun. Kahit gulatin ka o dahan-dahanin, ang masaklap pa rin. Sabi ng ganun, ba't ba ako naka-attend ngayon? Parang alam ni Brother Obet yung dinidiscuss. Eh yung broken, the broken heart, may iba pa ba? Mga biktima ng extrajudicial, alam nyo na yun eh. Extrajudicial feelings, yung mga kaya kang pakiligin pero hindi ka kayang mahalin. Oo. At marami pang iba. At you know, that's a very powerful sigh. At saka broke. Way kwarta. Walang pera. Pag ang, naku, generalization ito, nagpi-philosophy pa naman ako, but hasty generalization, pero pagbigyan nyo na, ang init ng ulo ng mga madre de familia pag walang pera. Eh, ang hirap naman kasing mag-budget pag walang iba-budget. But I want to speak to the newlyweds, may mga newlyweds dito, to those who've been married for quite a time, for those who've married for too long, tsaka nagpe-pray na maging married. Yung binabakantehan nila minsan yung tabi nila, one of these days, may katabi na ako, brother. Okay. Kasi sana, huwag pag-aawayan ang pera. So these are the things that bring people to the Lord, which is good. Kapag sinabi mo, oh my gosh, ganyan ako dati, lahat-lahat. Pero look at you now. You have moved on already. But still, we will study this powerful emotion. Especially that one philosopher, I think it was Aristotle who said that the goal of life is to be happy. Alam niyo na mga philosophers, pagka bumitaw sila ng salita, it's subject to a lot of discussions. Sabi mo sa katabi mo, ganun yun. Ito yung argument. If happiness is the purpose of life, is sadness the enemy? Kasi yun yung nangyayari. Kalaban ba ang kalungkutan? I have to admit, I have a confession to make. Ayaw kong lumungkot. I make my own, I gave a recollection yesterday, malapit lang sa Mabalacat, Pampanga. I'm a professor in St. Anthony College of Technology. So dilema na nagtuturo, tapos missionaryo ka, tuwing may graduating students, papapuntahin ka nila doon, magbibigay kang recollection. At may tinanong sila, Sir Obet, Professor O, and they call me that way, what does it mean to be in the dark? Grabe naman mga tanong. Kung ano-anong pinapanood, siguro nanonood ng Bander, ano may? Kung ano-anong mga pinapanood sa Netflix. What does it mean to be in the dark? Sabi ko, sasagutin kita sa isang kanta. Wake me up inside! Wake me up inside! Save me from the nothing I become. Bring me to life. Your sadness or any negative emotion for that matter will bring you to the point, makinig, mabuti, na mararamdaman mong nothing ka. Toxic people are experts in making you feel that you're nothing. You know that you're in a toxic friendship, toxic relationship, toxic company. If they do not recognize your worth, they do not recognize that you're good. Magka rin naman papasok bukas ng Lunes, pagpasok mo, hey, please recognize my worth. Huwag naman ganun. Minsan obvious eh. May mga taong walang feeling. Pero that's saving yourself from the nothing I become. And sadness has that power. Pero masyadong na de-demonify. Grabe namang word yon. Nade-demonify ang sadness. Eh, tingnan mo ah. It's human to be sad. Sino sa inyo ang nalungkot na? Taas ang kamay. Sige, bibigyan ko kayong 10 segundo. Pumanap ng kamarites. Magkwento ka sa katabi mo, bakit ka nalungkot recently? Sige. Yung iba, sabi nga ni brother, yung pera. Sige, 10 seconds. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. Okay, stop na. Tuloy mamaya. Mag-LG kayo. Mamaya may pa-coffee. Mamaya may pa-bread tayo dyan. Can we give a big hand to the Lord? Dahil akala natin ang kabaliktaran ng happiness, ng happy purpose of life is sadness, I debunk that. It's wrong. Because When we say happy life, it's the fulfillment of your capacity as a human being. The opposite of that happy life, that ideal life is, ask me what? Save me from the nothing I become. Matalinong tao na ang baba ng tingin sa sarili. Yun yung talagang ultimate goal ng demonyo if there is, or ng evil ng mundo. Ang hindi ka bumilib na ikaw ang ultimate, beautiful, majestic, fantastic, amazing creation of God. Wala na iba pang gagandang nilikha ang Diyos, kundi tingnan ng katabi. Yan. Sabi mo naman, wow! Kasi yung iba sabi, because we are created in the likeness and image of God. Amen? Kaya lang ito, because of the wrong, buti na lang umaten tayo ngayon. Even I, as I prepare this, sabi ko, Lord, I'm gonna be preaching this passionately. Kasi once upon a time in my life, nilalabanan ko yung pagiging malungkot. I made a personal experiment. You know that aside from preaching, and aside from teaching and studying, I love working out. And then I made an experiment with all the range of emotions. The four main emotions. Sad, mad, glad, scared. Alam ninyo, nag-push-ups ako. Mamaya na yung sad. Mad! Galit ako. Dami, mga around 120. Tapos papahinga lang ako. Kasi the Lord gave me a weird physical body. Because I just rest 5 minutes, I can do 100 push-ups again. So push-ups ako ng galit. Mga 120 na gawa ako. Galit eh. Tapos nag-push-up ako. Sad, scared. Parang 60 lang. Ito na. I did my push-up sad. Sumadsad ako. Kaya sabi ko, gagawin ko lahat para hindi lumungkot. Pero I conditioned myself to be happy. I think I was able to do 150. Uy, huwag niyong kukumpara sarili niyo. I've been doing this since I was young. I'm a boxer. I'm a street boxer. Yung mga pinagpupustahan sa bagong baryo. So, sana happy palagi. See? Ginagawang sobrang evil ng sadness. Totoo naman. Pero it's normal to feel sad. Yes? Halimbawa, I will affect your emotions now. Tapos na po yung talk. Goodbye. Oh, di ba na nakakalungkot? Ganun yun. We feel that. Pero this is the point. That's why a lot of people try to get rid of sadness as ASAP. Nilulunod. Dati, pagka malungkot ako, talagang umiinom akong grabe. Eh kami mga waray-waray. Any person here, as you can very well see in my features, you're right. I'm not a pure Filipino. You're right. Because my parents are foreigners. Both of them are Samaritans. Taga-Samargid hinanay ng hitatay. Dito na hirada ako sa Samar, ako didi na. Ang mga isa pang alam ko na grabe mag-inuman, mga Bicolano. Nag-iinom hanggang magdamagan, tas ang ipambabanlaw nila sa ang over, inuman pa rin. Bakit ginagawa yan ng mga tao? Pag-iinom, pagda-drugs. May nadagdag pa ngayon, rageaholic. Ang tinutinong tao, kinat mo lang sa kalye, mambabaril na. At marami pang iba. Shopaholic. Dahan-dahan tingnan ng katabi, huwag biglaan. Yung iba, gumanon ka agad eh. Diba? Bakit? Kasi gustong lunurin ang lungkot. Gustong bayaran ang lungkot. However, this is the point. Sadness comes when we experience loss. Unawain mo sarili mo, pag nawalan ka, malulungkot ka. Yung isa nga sa inaanak ko na umaaten dito, ang galing ng Diyos. Sa mga dog lovers, this is tragic if you hear the news. Nawalan siya ng dog. Pero habang nagdurusa siya, nakita siya ng kapitbahay na Inglesero. Gosh, what is that beautiful woman doing? So he went down and said, "What are you crying about? Did you lose something?" Namatay aso ko pa, English-English ka pa dyan. Pero alam nyo, doon na ipanganak ang kanilang love life. Si Karen ito at saka si Joseph Baguio. Oh, sa mga musicians, yan yun. So, yan ang lungkot dahil nawalan ka. Tingnan ang katabi. Tuwing may nawawala dyan sa katabi mo, lumulungkot yan. Ang tanong, pag ikaw ba wala ka sa piling niya, naks, malulungkot din siya. And sadness is like physical pain. Bakit? Ask me why. Practice mo nga kung buhay yung katabi mo. Kurti mo ng konti, huwag yung ikakagalit niya. Pag yan ay social, sabi niya, ouch. Pag yan naman kagaya kong geologs, aray! O pagka Samaritan, agoy! Naku, Diyos ko, may astronaut to na nadapa. Sabi, agoy. Ay, grabe mag-English, waray-waray pala. Agoy. Anyway, kasi pag nasakdan din ang damdamin natin, we say, ouch. Pag social ka, ouch. Pag geologs ka, aray. Pagka geologs ka na nag-a-aspire maging social, muntik mo na makalimutan, ouch. Napapaganon ka, di ba? Ouch. Ganon ka. But you know, I want to attack it there where it is because difficult emotions carry special gifts. Totoo ang sinasabi ng mga matatalino nag-aral ng emotion that emotions are tyrannical masters, but they are great servants. Akbayan ng katabi. Sabi mo, I care about you. Mula ngayon, huwag ka na magpapatalo, ha? Huwag ka na magpapaalipin sa emosyon. Lalo na sa lungkot. Huwag ka nang malungkot. Oh, praise the Lord. Palakpakan natin si Lord. Pain says, may sinasabi yung pain because as you can see in the slide, pain is the body's protective mechanism physically. Pero emotional pain says, stop. Spend time to heal yourself and guard yourself so you won't get injured again. Pag nalulungkot ka na, sabi nga ng isang poem, rest if you must, but don't you quit. Kasi tayo nasasaktan na, arya pa ng arya. Hindi lahat ng panahon okay maging martir. Aray, brother. Di ba yung mga martyr saints? Kay Lord! Hindi sa tao na tinotoxic ka. Amen? We have to continue. And then with sometimes pag sobrang sakit na nararamdaman natin, sana hindi ko na lang nararamdaman to. Meron bang sitwasyon na hindi ko nararamdaman ng sakit? There is. Two cases. Two phenomenon in your physicality. That there's no such thing as pain. Physical pain. And that is called the Riley Day syndrome or from familiar dysentoma and congenital insensitivity to pain. Kung nanonood, ano bang movie yung napanood ko na ang pinakamatinding kalaban niya ay merong CIP. So kahit bangasan niya, durog na yung mukha, bumabangon pa rin. Have you ever wondered why Batman have difficult time fighting Joker? Because Joker has both Riley Day syndrome and congenital insensitivity to pain. But Robert Patutin, alam mo, ay, follower ako ng Marvel Comics, ng DC Comics, tsaka Marvel. Yung dalawa na yun. Diba? Gusto nyo to? Pag meron kang CIP or meron kang Riley Day syndrome, tatalong ka sa bangin, buhay ka pa oh. Pero durug-durug na buto mo, sugat-sugat ka. Pero pag nakakaramdam ka ng pain, can you kindly use kitchen in a sentence? Tell me, use it. Uy, wag ka dyan, masakitchen. Diba? Layuan mo yung mga bagay na masakitchen. Diba? Huwag gagawin yung masasaktan ka, akbayan ang katabi. Sabi mo, ngayon ko lang sasabihin to sa'yo. Pero dati kasi problema mo, alam mo nang masasaktan ka, arya ka pa rin ng arya. Palakpakan natin si Lord. Kaya may kaibigan eh. Diba? Sadness tells us, hey, stop. Not everything is okay. Heal. Pag malungkot ka, stop. Magnilay-nilay. Brother Obet, eh, ang lungkot eh. Eh, ano ngayon? Kaya nga naging hit ang It's Okay Not To Be Okay. And We're Okay. Tingnan mo yung katabi mo. Pag feeling not okay yan, hindi mo mahal yan. You've got to love the person, whatever emotional situation that the person has. You have to stop and heal. Yesterday, oh my gosh, how can I share this? We visited the wake of Reza. They're very young. Diyos ko, wala pang 40 yung mag-asawa. And then, Jesus Christ. Very early death. May tumor pala sa brain. Tapos sabi ko sa husband, because it's already been 4 occasions, 2 under my professional coaching, that the person delayed grieving. Ano nangyari? Kung kailan okay na yung buhay, nag-grieve pala yung puso niya. Kaya if you've got to be sad, feel it. Tell the person beside you, feel your sadness. If you're sad, baka naman hindi malungkot yung katabi mo, pinapa-feel mo. Okay. When sadness happens, this is my advice. Are you ready? Kung close kayo ng katabi mo, mag-holding hands kayo. Pag hindi, magpaalam ka. Hindi naman kasi kayo magkakilala. Okay, hawakan ng kamay kung close kayo. Sabi mo, when sadness happens, when emotional pain happens, feel it, but don't feed it. Give a big hand to Jesus Christ. Damhin mo, pero wag mong gatungan. Kasi malungkot na nga, magsasalang pa ng,
wag ka nang umiyak.
Sa lahat naman ng kantang wag ka nang umiyak, nakakaiyak. Kung wala ka, tapos malungkot na nga, pupunta mo dun sa mga kaibigan yung lungkot-lungkutan. Toxic na nga, pupunta pa dun. I counseled one person and we were able to have a breakthrough. And he said, Brother Obet, alam nyo na to, isi-share ko lang para sa mga nakalimot na and for the people who will first hear this today. Alam nyo ba na ang sadness and sorrow and negative emotions have dopamine too? Makinig, nakaka-addict ang kalungkutan. Kaya you better manage it. What's the best thing to do? Ask me what? Let sadness push you to the Lord. Yung may picture, oh. Nung ginawa ko yan, naiiyak ako. I'm an old guy, kaya yung mga kantang alam ko yung, if ever you have rain in your heart, someone has hurt you and torn you apart. Inaalam ng mga bagets. Am I unwise? To, yung iba, white-haired na, sabi, ha? Gumaganon pa. Run to me. Ay, gusto ko tong grupo na to. Run to me. If you need a shoulder now and then, need someone older, so darling, you run to me. Alam mo, ang sarap-sarap siguro sa feeling ni Lord na tumutong anak ko, patakbo-takbo pa sa akin pag may problema. Pag umu-okay buhay, nagkakalimutan, hindi na umaattend ng feast. Kalabitin ng katabi, sabi mo, buti andito ka. In the next slide, I want to show you, to heal, you need to do things. Let's revise the word, you need to do things. You need to remember two things. Number one, don't rush the healing. Ang aking inspiration dito ay sinabi ni Maurice Schwartz. Anybody here who is a fan of Tuesdays with Maury? Ayan. Sabi ni Maurice Schwartz, don't hold on too long and don't let go too soon. Huwag kang kumapit na matagal pero don't let go too soon. Huwag kang bumitaw ka agad-agad, karaka-raka, but don't hold on too long. Kasi lahat hindi permanente. So number one to remember, don't rush the healing. Huwag mong madaliin. Huwag ka rin magpanggap na okay ka na. It's great to have a safe space. You have an LG, you have great friends, and tell them I'm still not okay. Meron akong kina-counsel. It's professional coaching. Tapos 15 minutes pa lang. Oops, Brother Obet, only up to this. okay, we cannot go on. Okay, nang po nasasaktan na ako. And I honor the grieving process. Alright? Warning, if you keep getting rid of the feelings of sadness, you lose your ability to recognize sadness when it comes. Kaya, tanggapin, aminin, huwag magmamadali, huwag ding tatagal. Kaya yung number two, don't delay the healing. Kailangan lagyan mo ng expiry date yung kalungkutan mo. Kasi ang sadness parang medicine. May expiry date. Effective siya, damhin mo, pero huwag tatagal because any medicine that has went even beyond the expiry date will become poison. Sabi mo sa katab mo, ah. So don't delay the healing. Number one, don't make sadness your identity. Uy, kumusta ka na? Eta lang ka. Walang gana. Na-drive ako 20 kilometers per hour. Tapos nag-U-turn ako ng umaga. Naka-U-turn na ako ng hapon. Huwag naman. Number two, don't let sadness morph you into hopelessness. Huwag mawawala ng pag-asa. You may lose everything but not hope. Number three, don't confuse sadness with clinical depression. Tayo ganyan ngayon, uy, kumusta ka? Depressed. Alam ninyo, naalala ko tuloy yung kwento ni Father Jerry Orbos. Eh, late siya dun sa ano, sa kanyang recollection. Sabi daw nung ano, welcoming committee, are you depressed? Sabi niya, I'm late. I know I'm sad about it, but I'm okay. No. Are you depressed? Yeah. Two years ago. Umamin tuloy siya pa. 2 years ago. No. Are you the priest? Yun pala tinatanong. Because clinical depression is different. It's physiological, coming from a chemical imbalance. Ayan na yun. Huwag kang karaka-raka. Depressed. May power kaya yung mga words. Imbalance from thyroid problem, postpartum hormone imbalances, or vitamin deficiency, or seasonal affective disorder, or SAD. Tanungin nyo ako, ano yan? Christmas yung kinanta natin. In its sorrow, rejoice. Hindi nyo namamalayan, Berber months na. And no other time in the year na yung Berber months, sumasapit ang SAD, seasonal affective disorder. Kasi nakukumpara, ay, ba't masaya iba? Ako malungkot. So, beware of that. Let's move on. I want to share with you a powerful scripture. It's in Ecclesiastes 7 verse 3. Sorrow is better than laughter because when the face is sad, the heart grows wiser. Alam niyo kasi ang Ecclesiastes medyo passive na presentation yan. Kaya dapat ang mas appropriate ay sorrow is sometimes better than laughter. Okay? Tingnan nyo ha. Pag masaya ka, alam mo yung sound ng, ano, alam mo yung, alam mo yung mga tunog ng music. Tunog, rhythm, tune. Pag masaya ka, pag malungkot ka, nakikita mo yung lyrics. Diba? Ba't ganun? Kasi nga nagiging reflective ka pag malungkot ka. Kaya pag malungkot ka, i-capitalize mo. Huwag ka mag-emo. Pwede. Mag-moment ka para lalo mo makilala sarili mo. May isang kilalang Filipino songwriter. Tuwing malungkot siya, kinakapitalize niya. Pumupunta pa siya sa isang tahimik na lugar. Tanungin niyo ako saan? Sa sementeryo. Pero doon niya nasusulat ang pinakamagagandang walang kamatayang makakanta. Tanungin niyo ako sample. Hanggang kailan matitiis ang paghihirap ko? His name is Ray Valera. So my practical sharing with you, when you're sad, ayan na, do these 6 steps. Very quickly, tingnan natin. Number one, allow yourself to feel sad. Damhin mo, pag andyan. Yes, malungkot ako. Huwag yung, malungkot ka ba? Hindi. Malungkot. E ano naman kung malungkot? Tingnan nyo, the shortest verse in the Bible is filled with so much emotion. And the emotion is terrific anguish or sadness. John 11:35 says, tatlong words lang, and Jesus wept. Pati si Jesus umiiyak. Ikaw, tinatakasan mo ang pag-iyak. Brother Robert, ikaw umiyak ka ba? Oo, dati pinipigilan ko. I'm a friend to some Muslim friends. Siyempre, friend to some Muslim friend. The warrior ones are not allowed to cry. Pero nakakatuwa, dahil may isa akong talk sa Green Hills, may isang Muslim warrior, sabi niya, pare, munting mo na ako mapaiyak. And his name is Robin Padilla. Paano? Parehas kaming dating si Raulo. Step number two, journey with safe people. Tingnan ng katabi. Sabi mo, please, wag mo akong iiwan. Pag may pinagdadaanan ako, alalayan mo ko. Tapos ito, bulong mo na lang. Pag wala akong pera, sana maramdaman mo. I don't know why I have to speak this. We barely have 3 minutes left. Gentlemen, married men, wave at me. I wanna equip you something very beautiful. Mag-ipon, 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 mag-ipon. Ask me why. Married men, tsaka those who are getting married soon. Because there's healing power in shopping. Uy, kumusta ka na? Sabihin ng wife mo. No, no, no. Uy, ano na? No, I feel depressed. Eh, bigla ka nagbibilang ng pera. 500, what? Ano yan? Eh, ugali ko mag-ipon. Kanino yan? Sa'yo. Di ka muna mag-mall. Really? Grabe, oh! Nawala yung negative spirit. Na-exercise. Resist the urge to isolate. Yan, pag malungkot, huwag mapag-isa. Yes, mag-emote ng konti, pero spring back to life, please. Number two, speak with someone you trust. Huwag makikipag-usap sa toxic na tao pag malungkot ka. Because toxic people will just capitalize and, you know, baka sirain pa yung dangal mo dahil may daladala silang chismis tungkol sa'yo. Number three, be in your safe place. Kung wala ka pang light group, please ask people around. Brother John Jomampo is here. Baka yung katabi mo, isang light group head. Whether your youth, we have a youth connect later. We have a what we call the youth circle, the youth corner. The youth here are looking forward every Sunday. And we want to honor you, youth. Please keep on growing with us. Palakpakan mga kabataan. Number three, sorry I extended a bit time. Identify your losses. Be honest. Hindi, kami pa rin. Ha? May iba lang kadate eh. Huwag mong ipagpipilitan. Huwag kang mamuhay sa pantasya. Because if you... May mga naapektuhan yata ako dito. Kung wala ka na talagang pera, umaming ka walang pera, huwag magpapanggap and drown yourself relying so much on your credit card. Ang wala ay wala. Look, recently, I experienced, simple lang ito. My dissertation research is all about philosophical coaching. I emailed siguro all the well-known philosophical coaches all over the world. Wala sa Pilipinas eh. God willing, pray for me. I might be the first here in the country. So, walang nag-respond. But after a week, I can't believe my eyes when I saw my email. Yung pinakasikat ang nag-respond. Her name is Dr. Daniel Lasosa. You can see her in TED Talks, giving a talk about emotions and how. At binigyan niya ako ng... Ayun na nga, kaya ako malungkot. I lost my first opportunity to be coached. So, lungkot. Kung yung dating obit, wala eh. Hindi ko siya napuntahan eh. Namali ako ng computation ng time sa Portland and Philippines. Pero napakabait. Hindi lang pala ako yung mabait. But it's okay. Let's just reschedule. Wow, man. Ganun yata kung sino yung mabait, pinagpapala ni Lord para maging successful. Anong, mabait ba yung katabi mo? Eh di magiging successful yan, palakpakan mo! God is good! Identify also your needs. Alam ninyo, huwag i-underestimate ang kakayanan ng mga mahal mo na suportahan ka. Gentlemen, I know you. I know your tendency to solve the problem before telling to your wife. Tama ba ako, brothers? Pati yung mga bagong kasal dito. Alright? But please, Mag-i-emotionalism muna yung misis mo, pero I tell you, your strongest support will always be your wife. Sa hindi pa married, your girlfriend or your fiancé, sarap pakinggan. Diba? Or yung mga nagpipray na, sana siya. Pinipray over, nagtatangs pa siya na. Siya na nga sana. Siya na nga sana. Siya na, siya na, siya na, siya na. Diba? Because, ladies, you are drawn from the side of the man. Which means, ladies, mga babae, nanay, wife, ate, your number one mission is to protect the most vulnerable part of your man. I tell you, I could be as strong as I am, pero para akong batang paslit, when I'm sad, when I needed help, I run to Mommy Joy because she is my strongest support. Thank you, Mommy. Love you. Step number five, practice gratitude. And one of the best ways to practice gratitude is experience the power of self-compassion. Kailan ka nahabag sa sarili mo, pre? Or wife? Yung iba kasi, nagiging identity nila, martyr. Late na matutulog, gigis ng mga, para siya mga anak ko. Pero nagdurusa ang puso mo when you can say, mga anak, minsan kumilos naman kayo, supporta niyo si mommy. Diba? Sometimes you will have to verbalize it because it's called emotional literacy and assertiveness. Practice gratitude. Minsan kasi pag naglulungkot-lungkutan tayo, nakakalimutan natin kung anong meron tayo. Salamat sa Diyos, tayo'y buhay. Yes? What will you do to exchange? How much will you put into your life? Wala, priceless lahat. Tiyan mo yung katabi mo. Kaya mong presyohan yan? Who among you would like to feel very, very rich? Raise your hand. Count the things that can never be bought by money. Palakpakan natin si Lord. We're about to end. Step number six. Form long-term habits. Ask me like what? Ito, we're winding down the road. Number one, pag nilayan natin ito, sadness, if handled wisely, makes us mature and pushes us to deeper happiness. Anong habit? Yung pagnilaya mo yung sinabi ni Friedrich Nietzsche na the things that did not kill us make us stronger. Look, my dear friends, I know sometimes you look at me, sabihin nyo, I'm very strong, Brother Obet. Dahil hindi lang ako pinatay ng kahirapan. Dahil hindi ako pinatay ng mga pagkakasakit. Dahil hindi ako pinatay ng freak accident. When Robbie was still young, I had a freak accident in Nabotas Pier. Durug na durug yung auto. If you see it, you will tell yourself, patay yung nagda-drive nito. Wala pa nga si Reese noon eh. But you know what? I was able to survive it. And Robbie is turning 20 on May 30. God is good. And that's something that I want to thank God. Eh. So look at your life. Kung alin ang hindi pumatay sa'yo. Kahirapan, kalungkutan, pagsubok, intriga, bashing, pagkakasakit, depression, the things that did not kill you are the ones that are making you strong right now. Another one, we don't deny suffering, we embrace it. Naku, ang ganda nitong sinabi ni Obet Cabrillas. Gusto ko tong author na to. There are things that blessings cannot give that only trials can. And it's the training of your character. Tinitrain ba ng blessing yung character mo? Pwede. Thank you, Lord. Pero tingnan mo pag may pagsubok ka, kung gaano ka nagiging mabait. And I tell you, lahat ng pagsubok na dumadaan sa inyo, walang ibang direksyon, kundi, tanungin nyo ko ano? Kabaitan. Mga misis, may tanong ako, pumalakpak ka kung oo, sagot mo ha. Mas mabait na ba mister mo ngayon kaysa dati? Ang hina. Tingnan nyo, papakita namin sa inyo paano pumalakpak. Mga mister, mas mabait na ba si Mrs. ngayon kaysa dati? Yeah! Colossians 1:24. Now I rejoice in my suffering for your sake. In my flesh, I am feeling what is lacking in the afflictions of Christ. Ano ibig sabihin nito? Lord, pag nagdurusa ako, binabahagi ko to sa pagdurusa mo. Okay? Nagkasakit ako 2 days ago. And I said, Lord, itong sickness ko, itong ubo, itong trangkaso, I offer this for the healing of the people I love in Feast Valley Verde. And last but not least, because God invites us to be His partners, look at that. We are wounded healers. Pag may pinagdadaanan ka, mas nakaka-relate ka sa mga tao. Amen? At isa pa, 2 Corinthians 7 verse 10, for godly sorrow produces salutary repentance without regret, but worldly sorrow produces death. Kaya dapat godly sorrow ka. Paano magagawa yon? Kapag yung kalungkutan mo, lalong napamahal si Lord sa'yo, that's godly sorrow. Pero yung isang sorrow na worldly, lalong napahamak ang buhay mo. Everybody stand up. I want to end with LOJ belief number 18. Kasi may 21 tayo eh. Let's read together. I believe that salvation isn't simply about going to heaven, but about bringing heaven down on earth, especially those who are suffering. Kapatid, kung naka-move on ka na, please, within the week, bago tayo magkita-kita next Sunday, pasyalan mo naman yung kaibigan mo na may pinagdadaanan. Because the Lord heals the broken. I've been listening to an audiobook, The Power of Why, ni Simon Sinek. And na-realize ko, ba't nga may mga tao na nagdurusa at hindi nakaka-bounce back sa kalungkutan? So you will see here in the slide, the big why? Bakit ang lungkot ko? At bakit hindi ako nakaka-move on? Why don't you ask me why? Because deep down, we're asking the wrong questions. It's who hates you, who hurt you, and who harmed you. If you're focused on who hated, hurt, and harmed you, you will never move on. That's the wrong why when you're sad. The right why is this. Are you ready? Send shivers down my spine. Who owns you? Who heals you? Who helps you? Kaya yun ang grammatical construction because, look, the Father always owns you. Hinuhubog ka niya para lalong bumain. The Son always heals you para mabuo ka. And the Holy Spirit always helps you. This is our offering to the Trinity as we worship, as you raise both hands later. If you feel like crying, it's okay. Allow the Lord to heal you in Jesus' name.
Brothers and sisters, that last slide of Daddy O was very, very impactful. The second to the last, who hated you, who harmed you, who hurt you. I felt that same way before because weeks ago, just fresh, we went to the doctor and we found out a medical, there's something wrong with me. That's why we are unable to bear a child. And we were brokenhearted, me and my wife. And I initially sabi ko nga, grabe naman, Lord. Grabe yung pagsisilbi namin. Pero parang, bakit kailangan namin masaktan? Bakit kailangan ganito yung nararamdaman namin? But brothers and sisters, I'm still here because I do believe, I still trust and do believe that God will heal, that God will hone, and I trust in God. Brothers and sisters, in the Bible, there are 5 books or chapters of Lamentations. Ano nakalagay doon sa books na yon? It's all about depression, all about anguish. Why did we include that
in the Bible. Because the Lord knows our lamentations. The Lord knows our hurts. The Lord knows what you are going through. The Lord knows your heart. And He respects what you are feeling right now. So let go. Let feel your sadness. Feel your grief. Feel your brokenness. But the Lord asks you one thing. Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened. Cast your burdens to me, and I will sustain you. Brothers and sisters, we remain faithful. We remain to trust. Hindi natin alam what's the future. I don't know why we have this condition. But I believe in Christ. I believe in His love. Amen. And I will declare that today. Amen. Let us declare that today. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name.
You spoke the universe into existence. You breathe your life into the lungs of man. You parted seas to deliver us from enemies. You lead me to a place where I can stand. I'm holding on to these things that you've done. These aren't just some stories from the past. Remind me that I'm feeling uncertain. You never change, you never last. Make me wanna believe. Make me wanna believe. Help me trust in what you promised. Hanging on to your word. Every word that you speak. Every season of me. Your heart is for your people. Help me see your heart for me.
Jesus.
When my mind is full of doubt and despair, and I'm struggling with the promise of mystery, Jesus, I need you to help me. A love that goes beyond all understanding. A love that even death could not hold. Make me wanna believe. Make me wanna believe. Be trust in what you promised. Hang on to your word. Every word that you speak. Every season of me. Your heart is for your people. Help me see your heart for me. Make me wanna believe. You make me wanna believe. But we trust in what you promise. Coming on to your word. Every word that you speak. Every season in me. Your heart is for your people. Help see your heart for me.
Lord God, in times that we don't know, in times that we are lost, in times that it is hopeless, in times that we are in anguish that is already painful, Lord God. In times that we are suffering, Lord, we seek your presence. We seek your heart, Lord God. We want to know you more. We want to know more of your plans for us. Let us feel your embrace. For Lord, we are so weak. And we are easily swayed. But just like Peter said, Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of everlasting life. We hold on to you, Lord God. We believe and we trust in your plan. It is not our plan, it is your plan. It is not our will, it is your will. For you know what is better for us, Lord God. We know that you love us and you will never forsake us, Lord God. You will never forsake us, Lord God. So brothers and sisters, I invite you to lift up your hands and we surrender to him. We surrender to him, the one, the true King, our Creator, our Father, our Savior, our Redeemer, the one who is and who was, Yahweh, Shiloh, Jehovah, the Lion of Judah, our Messiah, our Savior, the Lamb of God, the Son of Man, Jesus Christ.
Help me trust what you promised, hanging on to your word. Oh, Jesus, we surrender to you, Lord. Your heart is for your people.
Help me see your heart, Lord. Help me see Jesus.
Praise you, Jesus. Before we pray for our dreams, I just want to share one of the lowest point of my life. It's so trivial, but it brought me really to the Sheol of feelings. You know my issue? My issue is that my facade, the mask that I was wearing is that I was invincible. I was a tough guy. But you know what's within? I'm craving for the affection of my father. Simple lang. Tapos sinubukan ko siya minsan. Okay na kami ni tatay noon. Sabi ko, sana yakapin niya ako. Miss na miss ko si tatay. Yakap lang. Malaki na ako. Eskulado na ako. Pero gusto ko sana maglambing. Eh, walang way. Ano yun? Tay, payakap. Ang lungkot ko lang nun. Tapos ganito, gagawa ko ng drama. Kunyari, maghihimatay ako mamayang alas dos. Kasi usually nagigising siya. Hindi ako natulog para makita ko yung tatay ko. Lalakad dun sa water niya na may takip. Iinom. Tapos dun naghimatay-himatayan ako. Tapos, nung nahimatay na ako, lakas, blag! Eh, okay lang naman. Alam niya naman ang threshold ko sa sakit. Ayos lang. Binabawan ko pa yung expectation ko. Sabi ko, sana lapitan niya lang ako. Tapos, haplusin lang. Okay na ako. Dumaan yung tatay ko. May inom ng tubig. Humakbang. Nag-CR. Tapos, intay ako. Pagbalik niya, lumampas. Tapos sabi niya, babangon ko rin. Tapos bumalik. Tapos tulo ng tulo yung luha ko. Walang hinto. hanggang madumi sa bagong baryo, ang dumi na, parang putik na hinihigaan ko. Hindi ako makapaniwala na may mga tatay pala. Mahal ka naman, pero hindi kayang ibigay yung lambing ng isang nagmamakaawang kaluluwa ng pag-ibig. Yun lang naman yun, tay, yakapit mo ko. Pero tinanggap ko na rin. Don't you worry, I accepted that. I was already in the Lord. But I stayed in my concern. I stayed there. Because I'm trying to build a resolution. And there's a resolution is the moment I stand up from my fall, I will be the most loving father that the world would see. I did not stand up until 4 a.m. I was wetting and mudding the floor. But when I stood up, I was a new man. I forgave my father because he was not fathered that well. But now I tell you, I think I'm living out to that because many of you have become my children already, at least spiritually. I'm calling out to fathers here. Please be the healing agent of your children's agony. Mothers, the world is so sad. Why don't you just extend your support and love? Or baka ikaw naman yung anak na kailangan pang magmakaawa ng magulang mo para sa affection mo. Today, we declare healing. Healing upon Mark's life. Healing upon my life and your life as we pray for our dreams. Raise up both hands in full surrender. Lift up your hopes to the Lord. It's okay to cry. Feel it. But we won't feel it, and we declare together, say this with me, one of these days, Jesus, all my dreams will come true. In Jesus' name, give the Lord a shout of victory.
Savior, the one will never fail. God, my Savior.
One more time.
I trust in God, my Savior, one who will never fail. He will never fail. I trust in God.
Praise you, Jesus.
Praise you,
Jesus. We will be watching soon, Inside Out 2. Please support the pastoral care ministry. But you know, in Inside Out 1, it was not joy. Not my wife, but Joy the character. It was not joy that saved the day. It was sadness. Because sometimes if you admit that you're sad and you need support, your body will be ready for some oxytocin all around you, available to heal you more. And oxytocin, by the way, is the natural anti-aging formula of the body. So if you're close to the people there in your row, around you, tell that person, I need your support. I need your hug. So please, give it to your friend. Lalo na yung mga naiiyak. Lalo na yung ngayon lang nakaiyak. Yung mga kamag-anak ng security ministers, lapitan nyo sila, ha? Yakapin nyo, ha? Kaya sila pumipwesto doon because they're the first to cry. My family, I love you. Mommy Joy, Rob, Reese, thank you for making me the man that I am today. I cannot live life without you. Love you so much. Feast Valley Verde, you're next to my family, and thank you for making me the happiest feast builder on planet Earth. Let's journey together. Thank you. Ba't kaya tayo umiiyak? Siguro sadness yung topic. We may be seated now and give the Lord a big hand. Thank you. Thank you, worship leaders. Grabe naman tong lineup na to. And we honor the courage of this man. Palakpakan natin. In that case, I will do the announcement. For all the ladies here, we have an exciting news. Let us watch this video. Love you, Mark. Make some noise! Ayan, Jewels Conference. The conference is open to all women, and this year's theme is Pure Joy. Ladies, can you say Pure Joy? Ganda, no? Pure Joy. Tas galing tayo sa sadness. Are you happy that we discuss sadness today? Palakpakan natin si Lord. We need to discuss it. We need to... Okay. And it says here that you get your tickets now via jewelsconference.com. jewelsconference.com. So it's online ticketing, and yan po ang ating konferensya. Sa mga mister na kagaya ko, alamin niyo yung date nito, kasi ito yung time na ikaw muna mag-alaga ng mga bata, maglabas ng aso, magugas ng pinggan, maging tigas, tigasampay, tigasaing, kasi moment ng mga ladies ito. Ladies, are you excited for Jewel's conference? Parang hindi. Ladies, this is for you. Palakpakan ng mga ladies. And it doesn't matter whether you're youth, you're single, you're married, or whatever stature you have in life, Jewel's conference is for you. And I prophesy something in Jesus' name. Ask me what? That if there's a Jewel's conference, gentlemen, one of these days, we will launch the Forge conference. That will be the gathering of all men. Will you be excited if we have that kind of an event? All right. So, alam ko yun, pag may Forge ang mag-aasikaso nun, mga misis, mga girl, uy, matan ka nun para umokay ka. Anyway, tapos na yung announcement natin tungkol sa upcoming invitation ng pastoral ministry. Meron ba tayong poster for that? Wala. Nasabi na. Okay. All right. Any first time attendee today? Ay, yay! Can the first time attendee please stand up? We want to pray for you. Wow! Wow, thank you. Thank you for being here. Just continue standing up. Did you enjoy the feast today? Umiyak ba kayo? Oo, kasi naging iyakan lahat. Is it okay that we give you a welcome gift later? Yan, tingin po kayo sa likod. Yung may hawak po ng kulay blue. Ay, teka, nagte-text pa po sila. Hello! Yung may kulay blue. Sila magbibigay ng regalo sa atin mamaya. Pero ngayon, ipagpipray. Yan ang regalo namin sa inyo. Ipagpipray namin kayo. We come before the presence of God and let's pray for the first time attendees. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Dear God, thank you for our first time attendees. Ikaw ang nagtakda. Ikaw ang umayos ng schedule nila so that they will be able to attend today. And Lord, make a lasting impact in their soul so that they will continue to live a life of grace and blessing. Patunayan mo sa kanila, Panginoon, na tama ang desisyon nilang umattend ngayon. And we declare, God, in your name, that starting today and for the rest of their lives, they will never be the same again, the way it happened to us. All this we pray in Jesus' name. And everyone will say, give them a warm welcome. Please go! Okay, you may be seated now. Sino man malapit sa kanila, offer them a hug. Ayan. Okay. So there are three ways three minutes daw na exhortation. There are ways to give. Alam nyo, may i-share ako. Can I share a joy? Nag-share na ako ng sadness ko, di ba? I shared a joy. Wala akong nadala. Usually, by the end of the last Sunday of the month, nagpe-prepare po ako ng tithe ko. Naku, wala akong na-prepare na cash. Buti na lang, pwedeng mag-tight through Gcash. So, yung ating mga tight ladies, kaway-kaway sila, Sister Eva, kaway-kaway. Ay, teka, nagsisharing pa sila. Ayan. Pwede po mag-tight. Sa mga may kumpanya, we know that tightings is untaxed. Walang tax po yun. They could issue an OR for you. Okay? So, the ways to give could be a love offering envelope, yung hawak-hawak nyo ngayon. Sulatan nyo ng mga prayers nyo, mga thanksgiving nyo, and then we will lift that up. Or, you can scan the QR code on the screen. Yan. Picturean nyo. Kahit hindi mo siya malagyan, basta picturean mo lang. Tapos huwag mong di-delete. Malay mo, one of these days, ma-promote ka. Makuha mo yung big transaction. Why not? I have to say this. Baka kailangan ng iba. Ask me what? Get ready. Smile first. Today, as your feast builder, I'm allowing you the permission to become multi-millionaires. Ayan! Kasi baka nakaalipin ka pa rin sa kahirapan. Today, you are set free because your emotions are free. So you could scan the QR code and give. If you're ready, everybody, stand up. At alam nyo naman, pagpatapos na, lumalabas yung mahiwagang bilog na lamesa dyan. Alam nyo na, ha? Merong cheese bread na susulpot dyan. Tsaka may sumusulpot na coffee container sa likod. Please don't leave soon. Please fellowship with one another. Get used to the culture. Yes, mapagmahal ang mga tao dito. You want to be a loving person, you found the right place. And to all the alpha males here, mga lalaki, do not be convinced that real men don't love Jesus Christ. Real men love Jesus Christ, and real men are very expressive of their love and support. Yes? Okay, raise up your love offering envelopes. Envelopes, thank you. Raise it up, wave it to the Lord. I want you to close your eyes as you wave it. As you wave it, I want you to imagine one of these days you will be giving 5 digits to God. Or even yun, 6 digits. May narinig ako sa likod. May entrepreneur sa likod ko. 6 digit. Why stop at 6 when you can give 7? There is one feast. I won't tell anyone. Somebody gave 7 digits. And I declare that to you that one of these days you'll break your records of earning. You will transact a business and you will give totally to the Lord. Say this with me. One of these days, I will be the biggest giver in Feast Valle Verde. Bless me more so I can give more in Jesus' name. Let's give joyfully to the Lord. I want to see you there at the back. Hallelujah. All love right. You guys. Thank you.
Brothers and sisters, let's turn up the worship here.
You are here as we lift you up. You are riding on our praise. Be known over everything. You are seated in our praise. This is prophetic and it's feeling in the air. We'll lift our praise and you change the atmosphere. With eyes open now, everybody's here.
Yeah.
Thank you.